This is Jarrod Horak for the RunawayHorse.com. Welcome to my preview of the Breeders' Cup Friday card. And the Breeders' Cup Friday card for 2022, it will be Friday, November 4th. And then I'll come back and I'll do another video later this week, and I'll be previewing Breeders' Cup Saturday, and that will be November 5th this year at Keeneland. Now, if you're interested in my annual two-day Breeders' Cup full cards, you can find those at therunawayhorse.com on my sales page. They will be completed a Breeders' Cup week after post positions are drawn. Now, for those Breeders' Cup full cards, I've been covering those since 1998. And if you are interested in purchasing, I'm going to give some examples of exactly what you're going to be getting if you do purchase my full cards. Now, right now up on the screen, we'll go back to Breeders' Cup Friday last year, and I'll give you an example race. Delmar Race 6. The Breeders' Cup was at Delmar last year. The Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf Sprint, 5 furlongs on turf. As you can see, right underneath the race, the primary contenders, those are my top win contenders. And Twilight Gleaming, number 6, was my top win contender in that Juvenile Turf Sprint last year. And she did win that race at 5-1. Averly Jane was my second primary contender. And then I had 3 secondary contenders. The secondary contenders are horses I like more underneath, but I do use those horses in doubles, pick threes, and etc. Now, for the wagers, each of the Breeders' Cup races, I offer suggested tickets for win, exacta, trifecta, and superfecta. So that will be something that I've done multiple years, and I will do again this year. And those wagers, win, exacta, trifecta, and superfecta, I will include in each Breeders' Cup race for Breeders' Cup Friday and Saturday. Now, the trends section is next. And in the trends, I look at historical trends, some of the key races that some of the past winners have come out of, jockeys and trainers that do well in this type of race, post positions, any information that seems pertinent for our Breeders' Cup race, I'll throw in that trend section. The comment section is next. And those are horse comments. And I give comments for each horse running in each Breeders' Cup race. So that's every horse on Breeders' Cup Friday that's running in the Breeders' Cup races. I have comments, analysis for each of those horses in all the races, and I will do that for Breeders' Cup Friday and Saturday. As you can see, Twilight Gleaming was my top choice, and then my other horses that I mentioned earlier for primary and secondary contenders, and then every other horse that's running in the race as well. You're going to get analysis for every horse running Breeders' Cup Friday and Saturday. Now, the next part, rolling double and pick three contenders, and I put those in order of preference. And then after you see all those horses that I in each race that I liked, and then the next part I have the rolling double and pick three tickets, where I show you exactly how to play how I like to play those rolling doubles and pick threes. If you're interested in playing that way as well, I just take my top choice and I key that one to the other contenders in the other races, and you can see those examples there on the screen. Now, for last year's Breeders' Cup, we'll throw up the highlights now so you can see how I did last year on Breeders' Cup Friday. And I had multiple good results there. And I do all the undercard races as well. So if you're purchasing the full card, you're not just getting the Breeders' Cup races. You're getting every race run at Keeneland for Breeders' Cup Friday, Breeders' Cup Saturday as well. Now, last year at Delmar, I had the exacta in the third race. My 4-1 top choice, Phineas, won an undercard stakes race. That was the 5th race. I gave out multiple doubles, pick threes. I had the middle pick 4. But Twilight Gleaming, he was 5-1, or she was 5-1 in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf Sprint. She was my top choice. I had some nice doubles and pick threes with her, including that pick three races 4-6 that paid 480 and change. In Delmar Race 7, the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies, I had Echo Zulu on top, probably everybody did as well, and had some winning doubles and pick threes. And then a pick four with her as well, races 4-7, ending with Echo Zulu. That pick four paid over $1,000. My suggested 50-cent ticket was $30, that $1,000 payoff. And all these payoffs are based on $2 wagers, just to keep it keep everything even. For that one, for $30, you could, if you bet $120 and you just played it for $2, you would have won over $1,000. Had some other doubles and pick threes, and then in the race 10, the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf, I had Modern Games, but that one ran for purse money only. That was a bit disappointing that ended up happening, but had that one on top as well. So as you can see, all the highlights that I had last year in that Breeders' Cup. So I did well for Breeders' Cup Friday, and hopefully I can have even more success for Breeders' Cup Friday and Saturday this year. So now we'll go through the races that are going to be run in 2022, and I'll start with the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf Sprint. Now, last year, as I said, I had Twilight Gleaming, and I just talked about that one. Now, in the trend section for this race, Wesley Ward's a trainer that's just done well in this race every year that it's been run. This is only the fifth running of the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf Sprints for 2022, so it hasn't been around that long. But Wesley Ward won it last year. He's won it a couple other years as well, and he's certainly going to be a trainer to watch. Now, one of the horses that he could end up running in that Juvenile Turf Sprint is Love Reigns. Now, she won easily in her Keeneland Turf Sprint debut earlier this year, and then they shipped her to Ascot. She was fourth in the Queen Mary, and then back to the States. She was first in the Bolton Landing at Saratoga. She's been working out recently, and that's a horse that he could run. She's a filly, and she could run in this race, and he won it with a filly last year. So don't be surprised. If Love Reigns does show up, she's going to probably be one of the solid contenders in that Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf Sprint. The next Breeders' Cup race that I'm going to talk about is the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies. This one's been around since the Breeders' Cup began. So the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies is a race that's been around a long time. It will be run at a mile and a 16th at Keeneland. And that last year, Echo Zulu wired the field in that Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies for trainer Steve Asmussen. She was undefeated heading into that race, and then she was your two-year-old filly champion. Now, she did come out of a win in the Frisette, and the Frisette is a race that horses that have been coming out of in recent runnings have been doing well. And so if a horse ran well in the Frisette, that's been good. That bodes well for their chances in that Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies. And the Frisette winner this year was Chocolate Gelato for trainer Todd Pledger. So she's one that if she ends up going in that Juvenile Fillies, she comes out of a productive race, she has good connections, and she's one that you could probably consider a contender. Now, the next race that I'll talk about is the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies Turf. Now, in this race, Pizza Bianco won it last year. She was coming out of a runner-up finish in the Natalma Stakes at Woodbine. Now, an interesting stat in this race is the overseas runners haven't been doing as well. The last European runner to win this race was back in 2013. So the Juvenile Fillies Turf has been a race for horses that are based in North America. One of the trainers that have done really well in this race is Chad Brown. Now, Chad Brown, he had horses win this race multiple times going back to 2008. With Merom, he had Lady Eli win it, New Money Honey, Newspaper of Record. All those horses won it, and they had also won the Miss Grillo Stakes. And then he also had Rushing Fall win this race in 2017. So he's a trainer that's had a lot of success in this race, and a horse that he could end up running in that Juvenile Fillies this year is Free Look. She was second in the Miss Grillo last time. So if she does show up, consider her to be a contender in that Juvenile Fillies turf. The Breeders' Cup Juvenile, that one last year, Corniche won for trainer Bob Baffert, came out of a victory in the American Pharoah Stakes. Essential Quality won the Breeders' Cup, the Breeders' Futurity and the Breeders' Cup Juvenile at Keeneland in 2020. So both of those races were at Keeneland. He won both of those races. So watch out for horses coming out of the Breeders' Cup, the Breeders' Futurity from Keeneland, since the Breeders' Cup at Keeneland this year. And then also, horses that have done well on the West Coast in the American Pharoah Stakes have parlayed that success into the Breeders' Cup Juvenile as well. So based on horses coming out of those races that I just mentioned, Cave Rock for trainer Bob Baffert, very fast, coming in from the West Coast, has just run his rivals off their feet in all of his races, including that American Pharoah Stakes when he stretched out in distance, and he would be a strong pace player in that Juvenile. And then the two horses that come out of the Breeders' Futurity that ran really well. Forte won that one by a neck over Loggins, and those two were well clear of the rest. So those probably are the horses right now to be considered the main contenders in that Juvenile. Cave Rock from the West Coast, Forte and Loggins, first and second place finishers in that Breeders' Futurity at Keeneland. And Forte was winning his second Grade 1 race when he won that one. He also won the Hopeful Stakes. Loggins was a second-time starter when he ran in that Futurity, and he was stretching out in distance in his second career start, and he ran a good race. So all those horses look like solid contenders in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile this year. Finally, the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf, and this is a race, don't know quite how the field's going to play out, but you're going to probably get an oversubscribed field, and this event was first held in 2007, so it's a relatively new Breeders' Cup race, and overseas runners have won the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf in 10 of 15 years. So there's overseas shippers have to be given extra consideration in that Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf at Keeneland. So that's my early preview and my early look at Breeders' Cup Friday. Now I'll be back later this week, and I'll be taking a look at the Breeders' Cup Saturday races, and I'll just go through real quick and talk about some of the leading contenders in some of those races. But don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment if you like this content. Again, I'll be back later this week with that other video. And if you're interested in my full cards for Breeders' Cup, head on over to therunawayhorse.com on my sales page. I'll probably have pre-sales starting next week. And those full cards will be done Breeders' Cup week, November 4th and 5th at Keeneland for the Breeders' Cup this year. Until I see you next time, good luck at the races.